thousand years. The Pope had been the king of the nations throughout Europe. He was supreme over all the monarchs. Then came the Reformation. The Reformation resulted in whole nations breaking away from what is called the temporal power of the Pope. The Pope claims to have two powers, represented by two swords, if you see it on the papal flag.
Mm-hmm.
One sword is the spiritual power, meaning that he has the right to dictate the religious belief of every man on earth.
Mm-hmm.
The second key is his right, called the temple power, is his right to rule the governments of every nation. And this is what he exercised throughout the Dark Ages. When the Reformation happened, whole nations broke away. Germany broke away, Holland, Denmark, England, almost France, and some others.
Mm-hmm.
And they assumed what we would call national sovereignty today.
Sure.
So in other words, the Pope wasn't dictating terms to those governments. When that happened, in 1540, Ignatius Loyola started the Jesuit order for the purpose of restoring the temple power of the Pope over all these Reformation nations, destroying the Protestant Reformation,
mm-hmm.
and bringing the whole world back under the universal obedience and worship to the papacy.
They were the Pope's army, really.
They were his army. They're mm-hmm. called the Light Horse of the Pope, the Light Corps, the Marine
mm-hmm.
Corps,
mm-hmm.
The Pope's bodyguard, the Pope's penholders. Without the Jesuit order, there is no real enforcement of the Pope's temporal power.
How many Jesuits on the planet today? In round numbers, do we know? It's not a huge number, but it's a very intense group of people.
According to Alberto Rivera, who was an ex-Jesuit who got saved, came to know Christ as his savior,
mm-hmm.
he says that it was 100,000 in his day, and he came out in 1969.
Okay. This issue of Zionists and Jews, great confusion now, of course. And when many people criticize the current affairs and policies of the Sharon government, they are immediately besieged and set upon by those who would throw the old shop-worn collar of anti-Semite around. To you and your background, it must look doubly absurd. People don't understand the difference between Jews, Zionists, government policy. It's very muddled and muddied. And, of course, that's the game. That's the way it's played. So go back, if you would, and explain Zionism in terms of how it is being used, in your view, to bring Jews all together so they can be, apparently, once and for all extinguished.
To answer that question, I have to go back to Ishmael and Isaac.
All right, that's a ways back, but we got time.
Let me take a minute. Isaac was the natural son of Abraham. Ishmael was the son of Abraham through Hagar. The promise that God gave to Abraham went through Isaac, to Jacob, to his 12 sons. That promise included a land promise, which you can find in Genesis 15 and Genesis 17. That land promise given to the physical descendants of Abraham through Isaac and Jacob has never changed. So the Jewish people have a right to that land. They also have a right to be governed by their own patriotic people, which does not include the Zionist government. The Zionist government, as we know it today, was started by the Jesuits, and it is controlled by the Jesuits. Shimon Peres, for example, deeded over the old city of Jerusalem in 1993 to the Pope, according to an Italian newspaper. This was utter treason to the Jewish people.
And there's supposed to be a document stating so?
Absolutely. It's easily provable. My friend Joel Bannerman, who wrote Crimes of the President about George Bush, can prove it along with Barry Chamish. So this is one of the indications that the Sharon government, the Peres, Chaim Weizmann, Ben-Gurion, all of them were working for the papacy.
And
all
still are.
And still are. Just like the PLO leadership, just like Yasser Arafat.
Mm-hmm.
He's a Masonic, Islamic Freemason.
Is he actually a Mason?
Yes. All those Islamics there. The Hussein dynasty is Masonic. That's Saddam Hussein.
Mm-hmm.
The Saud dynasty is Masonic.
Well, that doesn't surprise me.
Right. And the Bin Laden dynasty is Masonic. And Bin Laden's mother is a Jew.
Now, that is a shock.
Isn't it? Just found that today, out a couple days ago.
How do we validate something like that?
Because it can be proven by the people that live in Israel that they knew his mother. Joel Bannerman and Barry Chamish can both prove it.
Is that why he's still alive today?
No, he's still alive because he's a creature of the CIA.
Well, he's been our boy, I know. So was Saddam Hussein and how many others. They were all on the payroll and still are on the payroll in some way.
Right, all of them since 1932 or the late 1900s when that whole fiasco was set up. It was set up by the British Empire, controlled by Freemasonry, and thus the tool of the Jesuits. They set up that whole Middle East schematic over there, Iraq, Iran.
British Petroleum, all of it. They cut the map up into pieces.
However they wanted to do it, that's right.
Yeah.
So they control both sides. That's important for us to see. And the Palestinian people, although I do not believe they have a right to that land, and they would be easily assimilated into Jordan and Syria, unless we could end this agitation.
Mm-hmm.
They want this agitation to continue, so they want the Israelis to give up the West Bank so that there can be fighting near Jerusalem, so that in this fight that will involve American troops there,
mm-hmm.
the Dome of the Rock can be destroyed, that can be blamed on America, and mm-hmm. then America can have a jihad, a fanatical mm-hmm. Muslim invasion.
Wow, all right. There is some talk about allegedly, Sharon would like to move out all the Palestinians, push them across to Jordan, just clear them out.
Well,
that wouldn't make sense with what you're saying, though.
No.
It would end the agitation.
Well, it would end the agitation, that's correct. But we also have to remember this, that the Islamic leaders there in the Middle East, they don't want the Palestinians moving in their countries. They will not allow them in. So we see
What would your solution be? How would you enfranchise the Palestinians? They have a right under the sun to some place to call home, don't they?
Well, the Palestinians are Arabs, and their brothers are in Jordan. And Jordan is just a stone's throw away from the cities that they occupy.
They wouldn't call themselves Jordanians, though.
Pardon?
Most of them wouldn't call themselves Jordanians. They'd call themselves Palestinians.
Well, they can call themselves that, but again, when I have to go back to the Bible and say that the Jewish people have the right to the land.
Mm-hmm.
God gave that to them. And it's never been reneged upon.
Okay, so Peres and Sharon, Zionists that they are, working, as you suggest, for and through the papacy,
yes,
are continuing to turn the heat up, hoping for a conflagration, I would assume. Is that what we're getting at here?
What we're getting at, I believe, is that we're going to have a big conflagration, like you said, that will result in U.S. troops being stationed there near Jerusalem, because the Dome of the Rock has to be destroyed, but it can't be destroyed by the Jewish people. They couldn't stand an Arab attack. It has to be destroyed on the old enemy of the Jesuit general, the Protestant, liberal, heretic people of the United States.
So Zionists are not Jews always. You don't have to be Jewish to be a Zionist. It's a political cadre. Is that one way to put it, Eric?
Absolutely. The Jesuits are the greatest Zionists in the world. The high Jesuits of the Fourth Vow are the authors and promoters of Zionism. They're mm-hmm. financing Zionism through their Federal Reserve Bank.
How is it that the Zionists have gotten away for so long with jumping on anybody who criticizes them or their policies as being anti-Semitic? Anti-Semitic. That's a club they pull out and batter people with. They've been doing it for the better part of a century now. I think those days may be coming to an end, but they've gotten away with it for a long time.
Yes, they have, and it's been too bad. I think with the most recent treason that's gone on with Shimon Peres and Yossi Bellin in 93 with getting over the old city, I think many Jewish people are waking up to the fact that the Zionist government is not good for them and that they rule on behalf of a foreign monarch.
I have received so many emails from our Jewish listeners here and in Israel and around the world who do not agree with what's going on in their country. They feel like their country is not their country anymore.
Absolutely.
And in many ways, it isn't.
No, they don't.
Co-opted. Yeah.
They don't have any say in their government, just like we don't have any say in ours.
That's what I hear. It's exactly what I hear. Same thing. Okay, now I'm going to go back to the issue of Jerusalem and the Holy Land. I don't think we could overstate the importance of Jerusalem to the Catholic Church or the Western Christian world. Therefore, would it be fair to say, in your estimation, that you don't foresee a nuclear event necessarily in Jerusalem or any of the critical holy places there?
Absolutely not. Jerusalem has to endure. This nation will endure. It will not be destroyed until their Messiah returns. But I do foresee the destruction of the Dome of the Rock through some sort of military action.
Mm-hmm.
See, then the Jesuit general, I believe, will use the American forces for this so that he can create a war between the peoples that are his greatest enemies, and those are the Islamic peoples and the heretic